Oh, that's all good. All right, call the meeting to order at 12:06 PM. Jeremy, you want to take roll call of them?
Yeah, Hefford, Stats.
Here.
Leaper.
Here.
Decker.
Yes.
Crawford, Eaton.
Here.
All right. Approval of the minutes. I believe those, you were emailed those and those are attached, Jeremy, I'm thinking here. So if everyone want to look at those. And anybody has any concerns, questions? Is it the very end? Where is it? Is it the first
right
one?
The
it's the first one, second page right there. So
two pages.
Entertain a motion to approve those. Or if anyone has any amendments or corrections to that.
I move that we accept the minutes as presented.
Move a second.
Okay, properly moved and seconded. Is there any discussion? Which feeds a vote. All those in favor say aye. Or do you want to do roll call, Jeremy?
We can just.
Just do roll call.
Yeah, okay. Stats.
Here, yes.
Leaper.
Yes.
Decker.
Yes.
Eaton.
Okay. Opposed? Zero. Okay. Approval of the financials. Those are, that report is right behind the minutes. Jeremy, is there anything we need to know?
I'd just like to point out in this particular case, you do have what is our fiscal year ending. So September 2022, if you see in profit loss to August of 2023, that we do have a net income that from that year over $1,000, which is good. Generally, we have a lot that's there for travel expense, and I don't travel quite as much as you know that's needed. I don't take a lot of those overnights and things like that. So I think you find that's where that additional amount usually comes from in that particular category.
We increased on some of our income and the different categories, we banks and businesses were up a little.
Yeah, I was able to get a good increase in some of the people who had donated. There are a couple that had not pledged as much, and so I'm going to focus on those. That would be like your Bank Central. You know, we all know in situations like that, there's a new president that I'll be having a meeting with, so hopefully we'll be able to increase some of the areas and be able to possibly look towards our goals and come up with some new ones if additional funding's there for us.
The payroll contract with Northwest Tech is up a little. Is that like an insurance increase, Jeremy?
Of course, the state health choice went up and some of those benefits. So that's commensurate. And with teacher retirement, of course, it went up.
In some of our expenses, we haven't gotten to the budget part yet, but in some of those expenses, insurance went up quite a bit with the Woods County Industrial Development Authority, and we pay half of that. So that's a good chunk of an increase.
I have a question regarding the budget presentation. I have asked this numerous times. Woods County Economic Development no longer has any engagement with the Tourism Center in terms of finances or staffing. I understand that this is a permanent fixture on QuickBooks because if you delete it, we'll mess things up.
Where are you at?
I'm on this page here, budget comparisons
okay.
page. But can you talk with, I think Tricia Cody could help you to hide that so that it's not messing up the budget?
Yeah, I'm an expert in Excel.
Can you hide
many
it?
Many years.
Okay, can you hide it?
If that's what you want, if you don't want it as a topic in there.
We're not, we haven't done this.
And I'm trying to see, where are you talking about? The Tourism Center?
Yeah.
All right, well, we got that budget in there on the website, so does that go somewhere else? Or are we just not have a budget?
Well, that website was a was a tourism website that we've never done.
So we wouldn't have a budget, even a budget for that, right?
No, and I've asked, even back when Sonia was, so the director asked her if we couldn't hide this so that it's not clogging up the financial piece.
Well, we can completely change it as the website tab if you prefer.
Do you have the website for Wisconsin Economic Development anyplace else?
No, that's what it is.
Well, then there you go.
So we could just scratch tourism center and put website or...
So where is that budget amount for the website?
That is it, right there. The
$3,500, so you just allocate
it. It was just put under your website.
I'm not seeing it.
It's the one under Tourism Center.
2324.
So you're at Tourism Center website, moving across right there.
Oh, okay, there we go. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
If that's what you would like, we can...
Well, I just think it makes the budget kind of messy, and there's no reason to do that because we haven't done that in years, probably in decades at this point.
Well, what we can do is change that Tourism Center to WCED. I mean, that other stuff under there, I don't think is anything that would be. So we can remove the other stuff and just put WCED website.
I don't mean to sound persnickety, but it's like, good Lord, why is that still there?
Yeah, just move. You'll move that $3,500 into some other area.
Yeah, I'll just leave it in that area and just change the subject.
Change it to just
Tourism Center. We'll say WCED website, and then I'll remove those other things that are there that have zeros that have no purpose.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right.
Do you need a motion?
Yep.
I move that we approve the financials. Okay. To August 31st, 2023, as presented.
Okay. Well, I have a motion on the floor. Do we have a second?
Second.
Okay. It's moved and seconded. Any discussion? Okay. Let's proceed to vote. All those in favor. Jeremy, would you do a roll call vote of all those in favor?
Stats.
Yes.
Lieber.
Yes.
Degger.
Yes.
Eaton.
Yes. All those opposed, zero. Okay. Update. Discussion, possible action on the donor dinner and the annual reception. So, Jeremy, you want to tell us about that?
Just, I sent out the invitations. I had sent it out to our donors first, and then I sent it out to the ones we had sent it out last year, follow-up. I've gotten about 10 responding back that they're coming.
That was digital, so, the email one?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you going to do a postal at all?
I don't see any reason to do a postal unless you all tell me to do a postal. I was going to actually call them, and I'm happy to have printed versions of it, but I think that's quite an expense, especially when a lot of people don't even open that stuff till a month after the event takes place. That seems to be
Email, follow-up, phone call. Yeah. Yep, that'll work.
But now, you know, I'm a person who likes my little memories, so I will have, you know, card stock ones printed for anybody who wants to save it and hang it on their wall. We'll have that. But no, I thought the phone call worked out pretty well last year. That also lets me just kind of say, hi, how are you? You know, just
and
see you if they have any
needs. Do you
need
us to send other names? Like
if there's somebody you feel you want to make sure that I invited, definitely let me know. I'm happy to do so. Marianne, I sent one to you, didn't I? I think you've got it. If you didn't, then you're invited.
That's the verbal.
Yeah.
But the news media one, I think I sent out earlier today.
Are we going to have... Did we talk to the university about having some music?
No, I had that on my list. I saw that. I was going to do that.
Okay. I don't mind sending Carson an email.
Sure. Okay. I mean, I think you were going to, but also I was going to call.
I did tell you I would, and I know that I have not, so.
Yeah, and I can call as well.
Okay.
Just kind of both of us hit it at the, yeah, the same end.
Okay.
But just, that's an update on what it is. So if you have somebody you'd like for me to invite, let me know. I think, how much can the women's building hold? 100 and... Oh, is it?
Well, we had 80 some there last year, and we had plenty of room. So definitely 100 to 120.
Yeah, so
100. Are you having the same people do it that did it last time?
So yeah.
They were out of Kansas, right?
Yeah.
Well, it was harder.
No, I know. It was just, yes. No, I don't mean like
it's Sterling. It's Steve Sterling.
Yeah.
Sister.
Yes.
Your Place is
Your Place was the name of it, yeah.
And, everybody who I've talked to has actually asked, is it going to be the same food? That was really good. So that's a good sign. And it's the 24th of October, again, for anyone who...
Have you talked to Pete?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's already... Good. Everybody is set on everything that we need, except I did talk to our donor dinner decorators and table decorators.
Okay.
And they're supposed to be doing something. I can't talk too much about it. She's sitting right next to me. But
but guys, whenever we get ready to set tables up, Jack, do you have students that could come?
Yeah, we can get some Aggie Club. We can get some Aggie Club students.
Cause that's
worst case scenario. I'll do it myself. No, I don't have a problem with any of that.
Jeremy did do it himself last year.
We can get some Aggie Club. Yeah. Just let me know.
We had some adult students from out here, but they're limited on their time, and so yeah.
I know the FA chapter is trying to do something to get to be a Gold Emblem chapter. You know, a 3-star chapter. So I'm sure. They're into community service, so that would fit. So I'm sure they'd be more than happy to do that also.
Yeah.
And they might actually serve water, too. Yeah.
Yeah, that was another thing we need to get our
What's the ag teacher's name?
Chad Blocker and Adam Lloyd.
Okay. And so I do have a question. You know, last year we had the museums have a little table and booth. Kenneth Korn is the expected speaker. I always say that. He said yes, he's coming, and but then you just always worry about getting these particular officials, and he will have his next in line come if he doesn't. But do we want to have somebody perhaps from each community, and what sort of topic would that be?
Thank you.
I had a couple of thoughts of, perhaps we had somebody from Alabaster Caverns. We could have somebody from America's Oasis if we wanted to. We could have something from here.
And then we also talked about
the possibility
of ag-related businesses, if they'd want to set up a booth, like Farmers Co-op, Weaver Brothers, Western Equipment.
Just wanted to... one would be more pretty much alpha, I would think. The other one would...
Well, Tacoma is Freedom and Tacoma.
Okay.
Tacoma Co-op.
So I just was curious if you want... The only other...
And Buffalo, too, I think, and some other, aren't they?
Oh, probably.
Tacoma one. Yeah. I mean, it has several out of our area, too.
Right.
The only thing I would... thinking, yeah, we have, some space there, but we'll probably have to have space if the music thing takes
They
place
will come
as well.
And leave. They won't stay. So,
so it would be the, the booths, though, they would be there during
right.
that time when
yep.
they're there. Yep. So, I didn't know what you all thought on that. Yeah, sorry, I'm not winking at all of you. I got something wrong with one of my eyes. It's been messing up, so.
Okay. Was there any action that needed to come out of that? I didn't see any.
The only thing is, if you wanted me to approach someone to set up booths, any suggestions on that? But no,
I don't think that's something we need to vote on.
No.
What would you guys rather, state parks or ag? I mean, we haven't really talked to anybody, but if there's a preference.
I mean, our speaker is ag, but it would, just seeing what
who's your speaker?
Kenneth Korn. is the USDA Director of Agriculture.
Our rural development for Oakland.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Yeah, because...
And if you do want me to go that, who would you like for me to reach out to?
If you go that way, you
said? Yeah.
So he is confirmed?
Yeah, he's confirmed.
Okay.
Unless, of course...
He gets a call.
He gets a call from Washington, D.C. He was appointed by the president. That was how he put it in his email. And my response to that was, well, if you do get a call from Washington, D.C., I hope you have somebody to send in your place.
Do you know what he is, do you know what he is going to speak on?
I don't. I assume, though, he's going to just tackle that whole rural agriculture topic.
What all rural development can do for rural communities.
All right. I just meant if he has a...
I'll say reach out to him, Jeremy, and see what his topic or what he... And then that might drive the focus on what we put around it, I guess.
Okay.
Wouldn't that be the... If he's going to talk about rural development, but he's going to have an ag slant, then maybe we look at ag if it's going to happen.
Okay. And then do an invite. All right. I think you're good with the rest of that.
Okay. Item number 6, update, discussion, if possible action on the website design and renewal of contract with OC Digital. Okay, Jeremy?
Okay, so Kay and I actually have been tackling this one the last day, last couple of days. And she just this morning put some stuff out. It does not look
not
at
me.
All.
The other person.
She being Candy Brossman with OC Digital put some stuff out. Doesn't look necessarily the way that we want, but that was, I think, part of her situation with creating this coding. We talked to Marketing Alliance, who was the one who created the initial website. They're the server, I guess, is that how
okay.
you put it?
Marketing Alliance is who we have the contract with. They're the ones who framed up the website. They host the website on their servers. We pay them an annual fee.
Okay.
Let me ask this, because I am positive that when we did this, I think I even asked the question, was the website content something that someone with average tech skills could amend, change, delete, whatever? In other words, that we shouldn't have to always have to go pay them to do it or whatever. And they said yes.
Right.
You did,
well,
you did ask that question.
We did.
I did, didn't
you
I?
Did.
You didn't
okay.
want it.
Because we wanted it user-friendly. That was our
correct.
Specific statement to them.
Right.
That we wanted each town to be, I wanted to be specific,
right.
user-friendly.
So, Jeremy, one of the things that we all talked about right when he came on was, okay, what do we need to do to get this built out? Resource library, which he has got a whole list of stuff. Then what do you call that? Business plan?
Well, that's part of the resource library.
Okay.
It's really the resource library is everything a community would want. So SWOT analysis, marketing analysis packet, you know, that opportunity. Everything a small business would want. So that would include business plan opportunities, somebody who's looking to start a business. Demographics is its own separate thing. So that resource library is really anything, even if the technology center has some things they want and somebody can go to and be able to find and grab that. That's what I guess was recently just launched this morning. It doesn't have the look yet, and I think we have a meeting that is scheduled with Candy, with OC Digital, and Marketing Alliance, their person on Monday.
So here was my concern, Jeremy and I just talking last week before, whenever, and I asked, or he said, you know, we're still trying to get this fleshed out, and she's having to write code. Well, that raised 4,000 flags for me. I said, she shouldn't have to be writing code. This is something just mm-hmm. anybody with some average tech skills should be able to send to Marketing Alliance, and they can get it on there, or else we should be able to do that. Building content like what Jeremy wanted to do takes time. I understand that, but there should be no code writing involved. So we had a conversation on the phone with her yesterday, and she is under the impression that she has to do that, and I was just positive that we did not want that. First of all, when you go that route 3 years from now, say she's no longer around, you're back to square one if you've got to change something.
Yeah, we don't want it in some kind of proprietary code mm-hmm. written in a way that nobody could go in there and
right.
fix it.
Right.
So that was my, I wanted to make sure I wasn't just dreaming that up, but I was positive that.
And part of that is we did that because every time we wanted to do something, we did not want an initial charge to be hitting us again. And you get into code writing and re-implementation of all that stuff, then you get into pricing again, and mm-hmm. you're also to the fact that if you want to, but you can't get on without our code. So
right.
you're kind of, right. yeah. we do not want our deal locked up in a code. I mean, like.
Yeah, that's how I feel about it. So
I fully agree.
Anyway, we're trying to, you know, get all this sorted out. So I said to her, she's very nice and she's very capable, but I said to her yesterday, I think you're making this way harder than it's supposed to be.
It is, and we should maybe, what does our initial contract, doesn't it still read to their, to the things that they're supposed to be supplying and all that to us?
That's,
and,
yeah.
Being Marketing Alliance or
Marketing Alliance.
Yeah, so Marketing Alliance is still, they do the upkeep maintenance of what we have. And they are going to have a call with Candy on Monday to kind of work out what issues she may be having or what we need to do on that end in regards of what is it, what material she's producing, how she would present it, put it on, why is she coding, and I'm not, it's not my wheelhouse, so, you know, I don't know coding or anything or anything like that.
Yeah.
And so, with that said, Monday we'll find out more of what it is that she needs to be doing. I guess she's creating pages, so how to create those pages, that might be what she needs to have that conversation with Porter. Porter is the tech person with the Marketing Alliance group.
I mean, if there is a gatekeeper, that ought to be a gatekeeper, that should be you. That should be community should have the, I mean, you should have the ability to say a community, you know, if you want something on there, when Open wants something on there, then you ought to be able to put it on there. Alva, Freedom, you know, Carmen, you should be able to do any of that without...
without a big mess.
Yeah, without...
Yeah.
Three and a half, 4 weeks of trying to get it on there.
Thank you. You want one?
Well, what we were trying to do is have these additional pages created. So have the look presented a little bit more on a user-friendly level. And that's where she was doing those particular parts, creating that resource library, which is a complete separate tab in itself, eliminating some of the tabs that we don't need there, creating just what you would generally see on.
That was one of the most important features that we thought needed to be on there. There was the resource factor,
yes.
the resource feature that you're building. So, I mean,
yeah. And she put some stuff out there, so she has. When Kay and I clicked on it, I mean, I wrote a lot of this stuff, but Kay and I clicked on it, and yeah, there's a business plan template and packet, and there's
so there's downloads and hyperlinks and different banks.
Yeah, but it's just not the way we want it.
Gotcha. But that's the concept.
However she transferred it over, it's not transferring over properly. That's what she claimed that she had the right code for, so it has the look. When she showed Susan and I in Winoka what it was, it had a nice picture that was kind of an introduction page for small business. And then underneath there was like all these tabs. It was like, if you're a small business, here's a checklist. And you click on that and boom, a checklist comes up. You can, you know, put that as a printable option. But this was, you know, what she had created. And now this morning when we did the whole live thing, it really kind of just looks like a
piece of white paper with some
lines, and yeah, and you click, and there's, you know, there are forms that are there, but it looks like it's sloppy looking, and so
one of the things,
hopefully
too,
Monday we can get that resolved.
We want to have
well.
A demographics page and basically have our region of the state, including southern Kansas, so that someone can take a cursor, put on the county, and it brings up the Census Bureau Quick Facts immediately, and we're not having to constantly update it. The Census Bureau, when they update, then it's an automatic.
So, yeah, so that code would populate it, and then it would automatically. Yeah.
Yes.
But, you know, we were also, remember, Kay, we also, when they were here, we also asked them if you would be able to provide the demographics and all of that stuff, you know, on our site, and they said, yes, we can have that on there, we can do that. So to me, a lot of that stuff, they're already behind the eight ball on what they're supposed to be
doing.
The marketing.
What they set their
clients.
Yes.
Yeah. I think they have a demographic page. It's just, you know,
it's clunky. It's just a
bunch
of text.
Well, I mean, it's for what they told us they could do.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And for what they're providing,
mm-hmm.
there is some distance.
And, of course, I wasn't there with that
right.
world.
I understand. I understand, but like Kay's deal, where what was told us on user-friendly,
yeah.
They told us about the ability to be quickly have it engaged and all that, and to where it would be very visible, very useful, you know, very usable to people getting on to look at all sites. That's been a little bit slow.
Like a kind of a trial run deal. I mean, we're not locked into a long term contract, right? It was a much shorter period.
That's with
digital.
The OC Digital,
that's a month-by-month thing.
Yeah, in fact, we had done that contract, I believe it was May to August, and, you know, there's that portion. And then it's $199 a month to have her continue to
and here's,
do this
but,
content.
But by August, was it where you wanted it to? Okay, so that would be my question.
Yes, that's where she's... Maybe. Supposed to have.
That would be that meeting Monday.
Hopefully that meeting Monday.
So,
the content that's there and, you know, some of the stuff that provided that we saw this morning, that's a good chunk of what we wanted. Not sure, though, about the building and sites portion when she sent us a screenshot there and we went,
that looks terrible.
It looks like it hadn't changed from the previous.
You know, the worst thing about computer contracts yearly, whether it be whatever, and like coding, like Kay said, I'd be filling an agreement. They get to the point they own that stuff. And if you don't re-up with them,
then all of
a sudden that disappears. And like Kay said, we start over.
That's one thing in our
initial startup.
Well, and that would
our agreement says that they do not own that stuff.
And that would be my question too, Jeremy, is how much, and you've got a better feel for it, Kay sounds like she does too, is it seems like your meeting coming up Monday and us having this meeting today spurred getting some of this done.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so I don't want us to be in a situation where we have to incentivize getting it done because we're going to meet about your contract. Oh, I'm going to throw all this stuff out. And I'm not saying that's why. It just seems like
it kind of feels that way.
Yes.
I did tell her, I said, look, I mean, because she was having this coding issue, I was like, look, you have, I want to have something to be able to present by our meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So there is that.
Gotcha.
So I'm thinking she threw that stuff there, like, well, at least there's something. She's still having this whole coding issue, which hopefully will be fixed Monday. However, if we're going into the conversation of how to do this, I am about a month-to-month situation, even if... I don't feel an annual is something I would look at at all at this time.
Sound like it's
here's my thing, but I'm not a tech person, but I've built a lot of websites, providing content, making it get done. This could be done in 30 days.
Oh yeah.
It's not rocket science.
Actually, the right company could get it done in
probably way less.
3 days.
Yeah, probably way less.
Yeah.
A lot of those.
Because we built some huge websites at Career Tech that was done in 3 days. Mm-hmm. I mean.
So we need to get this.
And I'm up done. For, you know, if this is not working, I'm up for any other suggestions.
Well,
you know, this
I
is
think
who
we go
have.
Back to Marketing Alliance and say, we need this done. You guys said you could do it.
I think, well, Marketing Alliance is a very, they have a heftier price. That's definitely for sure. And if we're wanting them to do new content, you saw on there, there's like 5,000 here, 3,000 there, 2,000 there.
We'll have to look at our contract with them. But, you know, this should not be that hard. And quite frankly, we need to be able to have this on a loop-to-loop video for our donor dinner, so anybody that comes can look at the website and any aspect of it. That ought to be a goal, I think.
So where do we need to go from here on this action? Is this something that we want to continue?
Well, right now, I think
based on your evaluation,
well, I think
your progress.
Yeah, you know, it may just be a month, but
that's what I mean.
Yeah,
that authority to.
Yeah. I think that's what you're looking at least right now, see how the Monday meeting goes, and if we can start to build that content, like you were saying, somebody should be able to do it 3 days. If that's not the case, then we will have to look elsewhere of somebody else who could.
But it looks like to me that Marketing Alliance, all that stuff, they said, no, we can do that, we can do that, we can do that. They have not. So
yeah, I know they, you know, before I was there, they created the website and they generated these pages. They also had a fee for an up-to-date, I think, kind of a mapping type page of sorts that
GIS
had
stuff.
no purpose for us.
We don't need that.
To spend what could be, I'm not,
right.
This is not the price, but it was in the thousands. Yes. There's no reason for that. So they were paid to do something, and in the portions, as Kay and I went in QuickBooks, we saw there's like a 5,000 here and a 3,000 here, 2,000. And that, I guess, whatever those payments were, those are the services that are done. So if we want them to create some new stuff for us, they're probably
with Google Maps and Google Earth, that don't need a whole bunch of stuff on there.
Yeah. Which is why we also hired the OC Digital, because we thought that will be, you know, what they can be able to produce that content and allow us to have a page that's a resource page, and you can go to that resource page and see a nice library there and click under the letter A and see Alpha and have a whole bunch of stuff, or, you know, however.
Right.
I mean, with all these large language models and search and everything, I just don't think there's as much of
it's
need.
Not.
Because anytime I want to look at something,
you just
I just go look. Mm-hmm. I don't know that spending a lot of resources on this is prudent, but I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, I agree with you, and if we have some basics, somebody's moving a company here, they need to know who the utilities are, they need to know what locations are available. If they're doing a broader search, they need to know some demographics, you know, what kind of a market are we looking at. And you've got your resource library is excellent. I think that's a great tool that has been needed.
I think, and one thing that I had, I didn't go to IEDC this year because I went last year, and honestly, I don't feel it's something that you need to do every month. But one thing I did get from somebody who did go, it's kind of how we bounce off each other, is a from another economic developer, and it's a chart of what your website should have on it. Mm-hmm. And number one is workforce statistics, demographics, quality of life information, incentive information. So we have this list, and that's kind of what I was going to also be basing on, what we want to have on ours, if that's the case.
I mean, we're not talking about, it's not like we're a bank or like, say, even Northwestern, where you have a proprietary system that where you're enrolling or checking accounts, that we've got this program running. You're basically, our website's basically informative and has links that populate and fill in information and then things to download. I mean, that's really what it is. So there's nothing. There isn't any special code they're having to write to make that website do things if somebody goes there and types in something. I mean, it's just using search stuff.
Your lady that presented last year, probably gave more information in an hour than
oh, right. Yeah.
She gave more information than in an hour than anything that I've heard about based on the community. That I mean, mm-hmm. I thought that was as good a talk, informative talk.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've heard some, you know, some things of more motivation, but informative talk, that's about as good as you can make it, because I mean, she had a lot of stuff and told what sources were there and what was available.
Right.
And I'm sitting there and thinking, that's the kind of stuff that as a mm-hmm. committee or as a whatever, as we provide, because I'm sitting there thinking, if I'm a business, I'm crazy that I don't get that gal out here and use her, because right. I mean, she had
right.
She yeah, who was that? What's her name?
Christy Isles.
I mean, she no, could have built a
yeah.
a basic for any company I wanted. She could even build a loan source if I wanted to do that as a business in this town, because of all the information that she could throw together.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just like, wow, yeah. as good as you could make it. That was good. She's really good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and she's someone that we get all the information that we want from her and be able to.
This Mr. Corn has got he's got some pressure on him if he's as good as she was.
Kenneth Corn was selected by request.
There's a little bit of a maybe hoping this might push the arena project just a little bit. I don't think he's been here.
Yeah.
If he has, it was under the radar. I don't think he's been
here. I think it's
But I know that there's a request for him. They wanted him to come to the turkey hunt, but Code of Ethics does not allow him to come. He was excited to come, but due to that, he was not unable to, so I requested, well, would you be interested in this donor dinner?
Yeah, that's another oxymoron there. Yeah.
Code of Ethics.
Yeah.
It's like government intelligence.
It's funny. He said,
we should review that.
Yeah.
Said, yes, I'll be there for the turkey hunt. Said, I can't be there for the turkey hunt. Well, and like I was saying, you know, this particular part that was just sent to me, while the IEDC was going, I thought, you know, we want to also see about getting that on there. And if we get that on there, we need somebody to do that, and hopefully Candy will still be able to be that person. Otherwise, I will need to know of who do we go to.
We'll figure it out.
Can even by ethics, can he not be there the night before?
That's what I was going to try to see.
Maybe we need to rename it or something instead of the tree. Maybe make it a, you know,
farm tour.
Well, farm informational or something. You know, whatever. I mean,
well, the donor appreciation dinner. We're going to see about trying to get him early.
That's what I'm talking about. Have him
the day of, and
maybe that doesn't fall under.
Yep.
Of course, that's donor appreciation dinner. So. I guess the action would be, in this particular case, is that we continue month-to-month contract until we see that.
Do you need a motion?
Yeah, you would need to, because she is officially now, there is no more, but she ended.
So,
I moved in.
Month-to-month contract? At your discretion?
Yeah.
Is that what we're saying?
Yeah, that would be
basically
fine.
At the director's discretion to continue it?
Second.
Moved and seconded. In discussion. Proceed to vote. Jeremy, would you give us a roll call? All those in favor?
Stats?
Yes.
Lieber?
Yes.
Degger?
Yes.
You too?
Yes. Okay. Possible action. Discussion. Possible action regarding goals, objectives for 23-24, beginning September 1, 2023. Jeremy.
Okay. These next three really wrap in together.
Okay.
The first part is, you know, I'm continuing on with what I'm doing. I put in there, though, what the job description was that I was hired on. If you see changes that need to be made or something added to, or new goals, completely scrapped goals that we had.
What goals do we have? I'm sorry. What do we have for 2023?
Well, 2023, as far as what it was that we were doing, the way it was just the description of what I myself was doing as far as the job functions, which is on
we
the
used
last
to
part.
Have goals.
Yeah.
And
yeah. There was nothing other than continuing on with the development of the website, working with Avar, donor dinner. We had turkey hunt. Just so really all those.
Those would be the kind of things. If you put those into, that would be like a goal thing, if you could put those together. You probably have them somewhere.
Yeah, I'm sure I have like a list.
That's what I was, I think that's what Kay's thinking.
Do we want to add the medical recruitment as an objective under
another thing that you want on there?
Or I should say professional position recruitment, where we are, as a region, really...
Well, you might as well go ahead and talk about that now, since that'll be goals and objectives.
So, beginning about 9 months ago, I started getting calls from some medical folks who were looking at retirement, and they thought they had plans in place, and all of that fell apart, and Dr. Tucker passed away. Dr. Smith passed away, Dr. Lutz needing to, he has, basically. So we're down to one dentist. We've got maybe 1.5 optometrists, and we have two chiropractors, but those two together are only populating a chiropractic office each day of the week, Monday through Friday, so we only have one. Our attorney situation is getting pretty tough with Ed's passing, and our legal community is aging, quite frankly. Jesse and Jared are not, they're going to be mad at me to say this, but
they're not spring chickens.
Yeah, they're not spring chickens. Accounting is also a concern. We don't have an abundance of accountants. So, anyway, we had a meeting. Jeremy and I got a hold of some providers. They asked for this. They wanted to come together. They wanted to be able to share their stories. So there were about, 12 people maybe last Wednesday. Medical providers of different stripes. Not physicians. Or nursing. And the hospital was there, and they're recruiting that piece, and so we're really struggling. Everybody's struggling. We need OT, we need PT, we need speech therapy is being delivered online. I don't know how you do that. I suppose they might have an in-person speech therapist, pathologist, but anyway, so we met with this group. A couple of bankers were there. This will now, they wanted to meet again in about 30 days to see if we could develop a strategy. Personally, I don't think that Woods County Economic Development can do much more than provide some support in terms of information. We don't really have an incentive package outside of some space. And so anyway, is this a goal that we need to add? Is this something that needs to be like an objective underneath business recruitment? Because it is workforce recruitment. Might help Jeremy a little bit if we said what is our role here, if anything. I did have a phone call from a headhunter. And that's when I was like, okay, I don't need to be doing this. This is bigger than what I do.
Yeah, Jeremy, how would you proceed with trying to recruit professionals?
Well, I've already reached out, including Christy, who you like with OG&D, and asked how do you do that. They said they've never done anything like that themselves, but in finding out with others, other cities that do it, that they create a packet, an incentive packet of some sorts. You would want to advertise yourself out there, and so if that means we need to, you know, create something, if it's something that, you know, Jeremy, you're now assigned to do workforce recruitment, then we need to obviously have something done with a web page. We're going to need to find out what can be offered incentive-wise, and you know, just it'll have to be tackled that direction.
You're going to have to give up something to start this thing up?
Well, that's
right. That's what who's really going to be the lead dog on this? This sounds like
I don't think thing to get it I don't think Woods County Economic Development should be the lead.
I don't either.
The problem also with that is if this is solely Alva related, we have to offer it to Winoka and Freedom as well. I mean, you can't eliminate them out of that.
The only hospital within this county share medical.
Right.
But well, this is, and you have
this ought to be the probably be the lead of what
they would be the lead on that part, because you know if there's incentives or things they can do, you know, share would do that, but they might not care about the dentist because
when Kelly and I talked, because I called him and I said, "What are you guys doing?" He said, "Well, obviously we deal with physicians and nurses," but he said, "We haven't ever really looked at these other pieces."
Well, we've got three young people from Alva, from Woods County, that's in the Blue Coat White program at Tulsa Medical.
Trying to get
basically
here.
In rural, I mean, I understand that their commitment actually to go there is actually to go back into rural communities. I mean, that's what the program was established for. I mean, I helped create that, but that's the, you know, we've got the, you know, the little Owen girl, we've got, you know, Cheyenne Ferris, and you know, there's, and I guess,
Mapes.
And the other Mapes girl, she's in dental.
Yeah, she's in dental.
In the meeting, they had talked about a lot of what they had tried to do, but how it's been unsuccessful. And that they were just kind of looking at new ways to go about doing that. And again, if it's like creating something, what I had read and seen and done research on is, you know, other communities. Like one example I gave during that meeting was in Tennessee. There was recruiting people of the professions you want, geared towards what you have in your surrounding area, that's a, kind of an incentive. So in Tennessee, it was like a kayaking package of, you know, these are people who like the outdoors, are going to want to come and do that. This is what we offer them. There's moving expenses, but then there's also not like, you know, here's a, you know, $200 towards whatever you want. It's more like here's a $200 gym membership. You know, here's, you know, well, those are those sort of things. But that was the incentive angle. But I think in our meeting, what we were talking, they were looking at a better way of within Alva building people to
grow our own,
right?
But I think that there's nothing wrong with actually being part of our goal is to support as far as like trying to find some medical opportunities for people to come.
Yeah,
I think that's got to be anything that will economically improve Woods County at all. However, whatever affects this county, I guarantee you, medical or amusement or whatever is going to affect every town within this county, mm-hmm. and so every community. So I think it is in our best behavior or our best behalf. Speaking as us, we're representing the entire county. We need to be doing something to try to help do something medical. And we have got some new doctor. I mean, we have seen a little bit of some new movement, which I think that, like you said, Kay, that's a tough field, but competitive-wise, you know, even.
It's going to fall back on quality of life and what those people want, you know.
Sure it is.
The number one thing that was brought up for once they had interest in coming here, it was the spouse that was not interested due to the quality of life, and that's
we're not very good at you know, waving our own flag, and we've got to get better at it.
But the main part is if it's this something that we add as a new goal for me to create this whole
I think it would be fun. I think it would be great to add that on there as a new goal.
Okay. okay.
I wouldn't say create.
It's going to take a lot of my time.
Yeah. Not as the main objective, but as a support if you think they're the...
Yeah.
I think we just put together a recruitment package that any entity who's out there looking can basically direct a prospect to a website, say, there you go, there it is, print it off, here's a packet, because that's one thing that I felt like was not being done well, if at all. They weren't all saying the same thing. They weren't talking about our schools, they weren't talking about our outdoor recreation, they weren't talking about the fact that we've got a... you know, we're a mural capital, people who are into that stuff. You know, we need to do that kind of thing, so we can do that.
So we're creating a, I mean, I know the medical part, but I don't know medical part, but workforce, though, as a whole, like a workforce packet is really what you're looking at, more of a general why you would want to come here.
And I think that's more of a tourism type. I mean, not totally tourism, but yeah, quality of the schools, what we kind of have. We're really wanting the website to kind of be.
Yeah, the website
Because you're not going to have, you don't have any specific, like the hospital would have specific incentive recruitment things that they do that we're not going to be able to list. It's not like we're saying, oh, come here and we'll pay you.
Yeah.
You know,
$5,000.
Yeah, I mean, finding fee or whatever.
Yeah.
Because I told Jeremy, I said, I'm sure that some kid who grew up in eastern Oklahoma may not realize that one of the best kayaking plays in the state is Salt Plains. You can plop a kayak out there and float the whole thing.
I don't know
that. Oh, yeah, it is. I'm not...
What I was saying, though, with the, you know, if Jack wanted going for time and effort of me creating something,
no,
getting it, and then myself going out there calling because that's what I've actually done this year for the dental and got with the University of Oklahoma, saw what we needed to do to put something out there and advertise that way. So if it's I think there's certain stages of what it is that how far can we go with it, but if we're creating something that's a material base that we'd have on our website, and then they take it and go with it, you know, that there's that. Or if we decide, no, you, Jeremy, you take it, and you go, and you contact people, and you try to recruit somebody, then, you know, there's that angle. That's where it's going to take a long time.
Would it be possible, you think, Jack, to get Dr. Shrum and whoever her staff are that kind of help with some placement to invite them here and show them what our community looks like? And I mean,
we haven't done that. I think so. I mean, I don't know. Dr. Shrum is probably kind of out of that now. I mean, I've talked to her a couple of times. I know even in recruiting some kids and getting scholarships, she's kind of wanted to stay out of that loop. Mm-hmm. But I think that there's two or three people within that at that OSU Tulsa that would definitely come and present a program or do whatever, and at least we could have something to take back. You know, we've done a couple of initiative things, foundation deals over there that maybe that we've become a part of. Again, if we have that to present to them, what we have as a community. But I think a couple of them, I've been called pretty heavy. I'm saying, you need to come back. I want them to come back. But, you know, part of that deal is when they go through the program, after they graduate, they're going to have to go someplace for 3 years for an intern program before they can come back. So you're looking at quite a ways out. So you're going to have to talk about somebody that's probably finishing that intern program.
Yeah. And I think, you know, especially if
when you say quite a ways, I mean, like Cheyenne's in Sedalia.
Oh, I know.
Missouri, I mean.
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah, but I'm talking, you know.
I mean, right, but it's hard to, yeah, but then, you know, they see a whole other part of the world.
Well, I talked to a surgeon in Enid. He's young, new. I said, so why did you come to Enid? Because whenever I go to a doc, I grill him. Why are you here? Where are you from? How did all this happen? He said 90% of physicians stay where they did their residency. And I said, well, so how do we make that happen? He said, you're going to have to make your community viable and it's got to be at the top of the list on placements. Okay, well, that's above my pay grade, but I could certainly put the word out there. And he said, my wife and I, we didn't want to be in a metro. We didn't want our kids growing up in a metro. Enid's plenty big enough. And he said, we're staying here. So,
and that's what our challenge is with our clinicals, and I know the hot college too, is we go to Enid because, and we do them here too, but we don't see enough. So like somebody that was in a residency, you might only see XYZ thing once or twice, you know, in 5 years mm-hmm. in Alva, or you might see it in Enid every other day. Sure. That's why they, so well, it's hard for us to give them right. the depth right. of exposure.
If we could,
you know, we have to do that with our nurses. I mean,
get them over here some, but anyway, looking at all the professions, I mean, we're kind of in a rebuilding, and I'm old enough now, I kind of remember all that when some of the docs and attorneys who were here when I was a little kid, then when I got to be in high school, many of them retired, and we had to go through that rebuilding phase, and that's where we're at again.
Is that where the professional building came in?
In part, yes. Yeah, Shared Trust built it, gave it to the city.
So it's like the people that were born at the museum?
Correct.
That general.
That would
yeah.
be me.
Yeah. Yeah, right, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're going to need to... You have to use city anyway, I don't know. City's going to have to come up with the incentive, and you're just going to have to be the guy that helps pitch it. I mean, you know, because...
We can sure start out with just making sure everybody is on the same page with information.
Okay.
And so we're going to have another meeting probably sometime after the donor meeting. So we're in there to, and this time, bring in a broader, because we didn't want to just have a gigantic bunch of people and then everybody be all over the place.
Okay.
But that meeting last week was very, very informative.
That'll be it.
Because they were all saying the same thing.
Yeah. I mean, most people coming out of med school and dental school, whatever, they have a ton of student debt. So like Great Salt Plains, which is a government organization, mm-hmm. has a repayment program. Well, that's the kind of stuff that you're going to have to provide. And that's obviously outside of your wheelhouse.
So I think Jack has to.
He's going to. So on items 8, 9, and 10, those were discussion items.
Oh, okay.
Do we need to, we need to take action on the calendar date, correct?
Yes.
Yeah, the calendar years are just exactly the second Tuesday of each.
And maybe, Jeremy, if you send out, like, once, like, the month before, a reminder of an upcoming meeting, can you do that?
So, motion to
you
accept.
Got the dates.
Anybody want to make a motion to accept those dates for 2024 calendar year? Meeting dates?
I know.
Second. Second. Okay. Any discussion? Vote.
Jeremy. Stats.
Yes.
Lever.
Yes.
Decker.
Yes.
You too.
Yeah. Okay. Motion executive session pursuant to 25 State Title 307C11 for the purpose of conferring on matters pertaining to economic development, yada, yada, yada. To remain or expand, talking about the appointment of candidate for the Woods County Executive Director
this
Board
is,
meeting.
We just have one.
Yeah. We just have one. Okay. Do we need to have an executive session?
Do what now?
We just have one candidate.
No, we have one seat to fill. Is what I was asking.
Yeah.
Right. One seat to fill.
Just
okay.
Randy's
appointment of the candidate for Randy's. Just one seat. Randy's seat. Yes.
And, we have
and
two
then
candidates.
The compensation.
She's not coming to executive session. We already voted to go to executive session.
No, we haven't. I was just reading this whole statement. Okay. Compensation.
Okay.
So we'll need a motion for all that. That.
I move that we enter into executive session pursuant to Oklahoma statute. 25, blah, blah, for the purpose of conferring on matters pertaining to economic development, including financing, structuring, collaboration, or creation of a proposal to entice a business, company, project to remain, expand, or locate within Woods County, appointment of a candidate for Woods County Economic Development Board member seat vacated by Randy McMurphy, and compensation of a WCED intern.
Okay.
Second?
Move second in?
You have to read the whole thing.
No, you don't.
Stats.
Yes.
Lever.
Yes.
Ethan.
Yes.
Decker.
Yes.
Okay. Vote.
Jeremy.
Stats.
Yes.
Lever.
Yes.
Decker.
Yes.
Ethan.
Yes. Okay. Executive session compliance report. executive, Woods County Economic Development Committee, went into executive session at 1:04 p.m. for the purpose of discussing compensation of a Woods County intern and also possible action regarding appointment of a new board member to the Woods County Economic Development Committee. No other matters were discussed. No votes were taken. We left executive session at 1:08 p.m. Item number 14, update, discussion, action regarding Woods County intern. Carmay Jones, do I have any motion on that?
I move that we pay Carmay a stipend of $500 for the fall semester.
Okay. Is there a second for that?
Second.
Okay. Moved and seconded. Jeremy, vote.
Stats?
Yes.
Leaper?
Yes.
Eaton?
Yes.
Decker?
Yes.
Okay, item 15. Discussion possible action regarding a appointment of a new board member. The discussion would be the appointment of County Commissioner David Hamill as the new board member to fill the vacated seat by Randy McMurphy. Do I have a motion in that?
I so move that David Hamill become the new board member.
Okay. Motion. Second?
Second.
Moved and seconded properly. In discussion? Vote. Jeremy?
Stats?
Yes.
Leaper?
Yes.
Decker?
Yes.
Eaton?
Yes.
All right. Mr. Stack.
Thanks.
I leave, so.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. We appreciate it. So, any further? We got item 16.
Industrial Development.
Yep, Industrial Development Authority update. Is there anything?
Do you guys have any new?
Industrial Development Authority update. We have a new tenant in the Winoka building. Arc Rock is moving there. In fact, they moved in starting yesterday. We will get, as a Woods County Economic Development Committee, $1,500 annually for admin services. So I will be doing all the monthly, taking their stuff and doing that. The Country Club has requested that we purchase lawn equipment. And so that's something that I'm working on, doing contracts for that. It's just a kind of a, we get it at a discounted price, being the industrial development, because we get a discount price as the Industrial Development Authority. Taxes don't have to be paid on, and so we go through them. They get the equipment at a cheaper.
Who's this?
The golf club, or the country club.
And that's the Woods County Industrial Development Authority's decision?
Yes.
Okay.
So they're using their tax exempt status to...
Yeah, to help.
This
has been done three times in the past.
Oh, I'm not saying it
2005, 2000, okay. Yeah. It's just, it's something that had been done.
Okay.
And it was...
Oh, that's them.
It's an approved thing. That's just... an update of
gotcha.
What's going on with
that. It's not our action, so.
No.
Next, the executive director report. Let you know that the turkey hunt for 2024 is April 17th, 18th, and 19th. Lieutenant Governor's turkey hunt.
That's the first weekend, correct, of turkey season?
Right.
Okay.
We will have... same situation where the 18th is when the Lieutenant Governor will come to us and we will do the quote-unquote dessert.
If you all have business contacts, individuals or companies that you feel like would be helpful or whatever to bring them here, please let Jeremy know pretty quickly. We'd like to go ahead and start getting those invitations out.
There's a few consultants that, like I met at the Select Oklahoma conference, that I'll probably send an invite to. And if you have any others, if we can beat the other turkey hunt groups to it, then we'll get them here first.
Okay.
Other things going on, I mentioned that I was at the Select Oklahoma conference. I'm doing the monthly reports to all of you. I think that works pretty good.
It does.
Avard Rail Park, I'm pretty much going to be the go-to, the one handling the ARPA prep situation. And we're working with BNSF to just see options there at the rail park itself, possibly transloading opportunities. So that's where we're at on those. The if we were to move back up to 8 and 9, I gave you the budget. It's a, you know, just a projection that's there for that. And as far as staff needs, I don't have anything. That's just a month-to-month, day-to-day operation kind of thing for me. But it was in last year, so I put it in this year's too.
Do you have any upcoming conferences that you're going to go to?
I don't. The workshop that they're having here conflicts with the Teeny Tiny, and I'm a speaker at the workshop that they're having here, the SBC. And so I am a speaker, so I'm not going to Teeny Tiny. Next year, there's obviously workshops that will open up. The Select Oklahoma conference was a great one to go to, so I feel if they continue that, that'll be one.
I'll be going to the State Arts Conference next month and whatever community.
That was the only one that I was looking at, but once I talked to you and you said you were going, I felt I don't need to. So.
Okay.
And then, of course, things will come up. You know,
yep.
Red Carpet Country, things like that. Red Carpet was not a great one for this past year, so we'll have to see how it goes moving forward. Didn't really pertain to anything for me.
I have some announcements.
Okay.
A couple. Swimming pool progress is going well. About the main change from this plan here is we will have the outline of the existing pool so that people can actually see what the original pool looked like. And the plan is to either have stained concrete in the apron where the existing pool, or tile, blue tile, so it'll look like water. We are very close to getting bid packets. I think the bid packets are ready to go. There's some city council stuff that has to happen for that. Financially, we're at about $3.6 million, somewhere in that neighborhood. And we submitted a TSET application end of August for $500,000. We'll be notified on that by the end of the calendar year. And then that money, we're supposed to be shovel ready so that we can use it immediately. And then it is a renewable, so possible $1 million there, which would put us at 4.6 if that comes in. But we're making really good progress on the financing piece, and I anticipate that we'll be in pretty good shape. But we definitely want to encourage folks to go ahead and let us know if they plan to make a donation. We welcome that. Long term, it would be great if we had an endowment fund established to help with programming and ongoing maintenance operations. So it's been a long, long road since 2018, but the light at the end of the tunnel is there.
Great.
Freedom West is getting ready to build a new house. We'll start next month.
Awesome.
Yeah, 3-bedroom, 2-bath. It's over a block east of Longfellow School on Center Street. So that's getting ready to start. And we hope we're able to acquire some additional residential properties in that part of town and redevelop some neighborhoods, which is needed. And that's workforce housing.
Awesome.
So
that's very great to hear.
Okay.
Any other announcements? Information? Okay. Entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Moved and seconded to adjourn. Jeremy, would you take a look?
Steph.
Mm-hmm. Departed the scene,
yes.
Right?
Yes, he did. Yes. Well, you didn't have quorum, so I think it doesn't count, and therefore you have
still have to
stay in this room
forever
until we get somebody back in.
Jack has to come back.